Hi, I'm David Reed from the Florida Museum of Natural History, and I wanted to tell you a little bit about a study that we just had published in the journal Molecular Biology and Evolution. The basic idea behind this story is we wanted to learn when humans, modern humans especially, first started wearing clothing. And that's a really hard question to answer when you look to anthropological data. You can find bone needles, for example, in archaeological sites, but they're indicative of tailored clothing, when we began to sew clothing, and we're looking at something much older than that, the first clothing use in modern humans. And early skins that modern humans might have draped around the body for warmth would be degraded in archaeological sites, and so that doesn't help us either. So we turn to a parasite of humans, lice, to try and answer this question. We have lice that live in our clothing called clothing lice, and they are very closely related to the lice that you might be more familiar with that live in the hair of school children. I mean, of course, they live in the hair of everyone, but we always know about them because of school children. So these two lice are really closely related to each other, and we think that if we can date when the two lice began to diverge, because they once had a common ancestor, we could learn when clothing use started, because that opened up a whole new niche for this clothing louse that didn't exist before. So we looked at the DNA of lice from lice collected all over the world, and from the DNA we can estimate when clothing lice began to diverge from head lice, and we found that it was about 170,000 years ago. And the interesting thing about that is modern humans were still in Africa at that time, and that tells us that even though they didn't need clothing for warmth necessarily at that time in Africa, they were tinkering with that technology, perhaps for other reasons, maybe for adornment or for protection from the sun. But they had that technology already before they left Africa and went to much colder climates sometime later. They successfully colonized Europe and in Asia, where they clearly would have had to have had clothing. They probably got that technology even earlier. So some of our future research along the same lines will look at things like the peopling of the Americas. We'll be able to use lice to try and determine where the first peoples came from as they came into the New World and when they got there. So if you want to read our whole story, you can actually download it from the journal Molecular Biology and Evolution. We have published this as an open access article, which means anyone anywhere can download a PDF of this story, our original scientific research, for free. So look for it at the journal Molecular Biology and Evolution.